Hello everyone, my name is Sumit and I welcome all of you to BISP's self-learning video broadcast solution. Today I am going to demonstrate you how to display a scrolling news sticker on a VF page. So let's take the business requirement. What's my business requirement is? So my business requirement is that I would like to display 10 recently closed opportunity. So the page initially display the first three opportunities, the top three opportunities, and then scroll through the remaining. So if we remove the top item, moving the other up vertically and appending the next item to the bottom of the list. So this will be an automated process. So it will create a list, and in that list it will display three opportunities at a time, and then it will remove the first opportunity automatically from the top, and at the bottom it will add the next opportunity. So let's see how to perform this, how to do this. So to do this, we need to switch to Salesforce first. So I've already moved to Salesforce, and in this, if you see the opportunity and object we have got. So in this opportunity of object, I have got all the opportunities, and I would like to see the closed opportunity. So we have closing this month and closing. So I'll click on go, and we can see all the closed opportunity here. So you can see we have closed one, closed one, closed one. So I would like to display all these closed opportunity whose status is closed one based on the date wise. So I would like to create a VF page because I want to present this to my customers or to my users on my website. So I would like to create a VF page for this. So first of all, I'm going to create a VF page. So now before creating two VF page or before creating a Visual Force page, we need to create one Apex class, and that Apex class will be going to use in our VF page. So the name of that VF class, that Apex class, is stories. So let me switch open story here. So that's the class. Now in this class, what I have done, I have created one class here. So as you can see here, the class has been created public with sharing. So it's in sharing mode so that it can be sharing with all the users of this organization. Class story, and in this story I have created few variables, public date, publish date, and get and set the values. If we do not get and set the values here, or so then we need to create the functions for getting and getter and setter function. So I create get and set function here, publish date, headlines. It will extract the headlines of that opportunity, snippet, body of the opportunity, location of the opportunity, ID of that, and image. If any image is associated with that opportunity, that image will also extract. So this class will be going to use in our another Apex class. So I'll save this, and now let's create the Apex VF page first. So I'm going to create one VF page. So how to create a VF page in Salesforce? You can go through my existing videos where I have given you an introduction on how to create a VF page. So I write Apex / closed opportunity. And click on this link. So this will create an opportunity, this will create a VF page. And in this VF page, we need to write a code. So to save the time, I have already copied the code. So to save the time, I have already copied the code, copy paste the code. So in this code, you can see here, we have a controller class. So let's say I write here new sticker, or instead of news, let's say opportunity ticker controller. And we are also going to use the jQuery here. So I have already given a link. So this will automatically connect to this jQuery Ajax site, and from here it will download the JavaScript or jQuery JavaScript automatically. So there are two ways. Either you can include a script by using this URL, or you can download this script first on your system and then you can upload it into your resource file of your Salesforce application. Then I have set the style. I assign a style to it, list sticker, set the height, overflow padding, then list sticker, list item, that's the style of that list item. Then list sticker, list item. So that's the height, padding, and list style. After that, I created one Apex repeat. Basically, Apex repeat is a tag which works like a loop. So it will extract the items one by one and it will add in a loop. So this will work like a loop. And value is getting the values from the stories. So So this stories we are going to define in our Apex class. Basically Apex class, this controller class. And then I display the item date wise, headline, snippet and any image or with customization. Then I have added a JavaScript as well. In that JavaScript I have set the speed and the pause. Speed and pause mean that at what will be the speed of the scrolling text and what how long it will wait in there. So it wait for 5 seconds and the speed is 700 milliseconds. And this function, it clear the first element in the list. As I told you that we are going to remove the function from the top, the value from the top, the opportunity from the top, and then we'll get add the new opportunity at the bottom. So it will remove the opportunity, it will remove the first element from that list, and at the bottom it will add a new item. So it will add the bottom, so I call from the list it will extract the item and append to the list. So when I save this, I'll get an error message because this opportunity does not exist. So I create this opportunity ticker controller class, and in this opportunity controller class, so let's save the code. I have already copy paste the code, so let me paste the code here. So that's the code, and we need to change this. So it's opportunity ticker controller, opportunity ticker controller, and we need to change this as well. Oh, the name is OPPORUNITY, opportunity ticker controller. Copy this. This is the constructor. So I paste this constructor here. So as you can see here, first of all, I have created a list. A variable here, a stories, and this is an instance of that story Apex class which we have created initially, and it will be a list type because it can have multiple stories, multiple records. Then add a constructor, and in this constructor we extract the data from the opportunity. So I created a new instance of this opportunity, oops, and I select the ID name, close date, amount, stage name, where close is close equal to true, and order by created date, ASC limit is 10, so it will extract only 10 records. So basically this is an SQL query. Now to know more about SQL queries, you can go through my existing videos on how to write an SQL query in Salesforce, in Visual Force. Then I added the values I set the headlines, publish date, snippet, body, location, ID, image, and then I write stories.add, and this story we are going to use here. I'm calling this story, basically I'm using it here. Right, so we are using this here, stories. So let's save and test it. So let's test this. So I clicked on this save, and as soon as I clicked on save, you can see the page has reloaded, and in this page it is displaying the top three opportunities, and wait for 5 seconds. After 5 seconds, the opportunities, the record is deleted from the top, and then added a new record at the bottom. So it is like a so this will scroll continuously. So like this we can update our users, or update the owner, or update the user with the current opportunities, currently closed opportunities. So that's all in this video. So if you have any queries, if you have any issues, you can visit our website www.bispTrainings.com, or you can subscribe our YouTube channel for more videos on Salesforce. Have a nice day ahead. Goodbye.